Reaper is launching their own airbrush. Really? Oh, that's interesting. I'm curious how it'll stack up against like some of the main name brands. If I were gonna grab one, I'd probably end up grabbing like a Badger. I think they're like kind of like the middle of the road brand. And I wouldn't necessarily want to blow like, you know, $400 or $500 on an airbrush. Blow like $100 on the brush and another $100 on the compressor and just call it done. Oh, it's made by Badger. Okay, well, hey, there you go. That's cool. Neat. Yeah, I'll have to look into that. Put it as an aside, like random Christmas present or something. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know. I think an airbrush would kind of be wasted on me. I don't paint my minis. I don't want to say well enough. I don't paint them to such a standard that I think an airbrush would be necessary. I paint for tabletop play, like not like art display. So I don't know that it would be worth it. Oh God, Pool of Radiance is sold on Mythdrana. That game is so bad. Oh, that is, I think that is the worst D&D game I have ever played. Yeah, I could see an airbrush being very useful for like doing dragon wings, for example. Like, yes, I agree with that. But I wouldn't use it for, you know, something that was like human sized. Hard different. This quest, these are gonna be very difficult. Even with a level on them, these are going to be tough.
As you enter the room, a woman wearing a noble's finery gestures for you to approach.
Have I played Hillsfire? Yes.
To the door at the rear.
Yes, I have. Pool of Radiance Assault on Mythdrana is a worse game than Hillsfire. And I will die on this hill. Hillsfire is just a bunch of glorified mini-games that you can use to cheese out a character to bring him into Pool of Darkness, or Pool of Radiance.
Dame Gold's eyes narrow, and you hear the sound of steel in her voice.
Assault on Mythdrana is... That game is a crime. That game is a crime against the Dungeons & Dragons license. Oh, it is so bad.
The symbol of the slave.
It would be funny if we couldn't find this secret door. Okay.
Poorly disguised secret.
Negative one search. But we found it. This quest is super trap heavy, and the enemy groups are huge. Oh, I really don't know if we're gonna be able to get through this. First fight. Yeah. And we're cursed, which is more of a minor nuisance. I think Assault on Mythdrana's biggest crime is what could have been, but wasn't, because the developers were just so fucking incompetent that they released a steaming trash fire of a video game instead. That game is so fucking bad. Oh my lord. Ugh. The entire world scales with your party level. Oh, Dragon Strike. I had that growing up. Assault on Mythdrana is a worse game than Dragon Strike. At least Dragon Strike was not a great, but it was at least a playable scrolling shooter. That game is actually, I think that game originally came out on DOS. And to my understanding, the NES version is a much pared down version of the original version. But Dragon Strike was really bad. The only Dungeons & Dragons game that I would put on par with Assault on Mythdrana is Dragonlance Heroes of the Lance. That game was also probably some form of crime against humanity. Oh, shit, those blades hurt. Yeah. We gotta kill this war chanter. He's gonna just spam us with sound bursts and shit until we're dead. Dragon Strike? Dragon Strike was one of the games responsible for me, like the board game Dragon Strike, was one of the games responsible for me getting into D&D. That and Hero Quest Like, those were my gateways into to Dungeons & Dragons way back when I was but a young, drooling, sniveling gene. That game and its shitty little VHS movie, which was so bad. I gotta watch that again. So bad. It had Malibu from American Gladiators in it. Alright, here, primary target is the factotum. Cleric. And then everybody else. I'm less sniveling Gene and more frothing Gene now. God, Heroes of the Lands was bad. That game, like, it was barely even a platformer. Like, if you were doing platforming in that game, it was because you accidentally slipped off of a ledge and are falling to your death.
This room's
HeroQuest minis were pretty great. I wish, like, I wish that there were decent STL files of them, like, floating around on the internet. Some people have 3D scanned them, and I've printed some of those. All of the HeroQuest minis that I've painted are 3D printed based off scans people did, and they're not generally too bad, but some of them are pretty muddied. Like the mummies, for example. I was going to paint an entire core set for HeroQuest that I had printed, but the mummies, the quality on them is so poor that you just can't. DDO's like original backbone is still 3.5, yes. There are so many like rules differences though that like there's 3.5 here, but mostly it kind of does its own thing. But yes, it's like the backbone is still very much 3.5. Spoonie showed you how bad. Oh man, I mean, that VHS was really bad. It was really bad. I'm sure Spoonie did not help anything, but the game itself was pretty good. It was a like an excellent like Babby's first D&D game. Absolutely excellent in that regard. And I keep jumping over this because there are traps there. For anyone who may be wondering, oh, 287 damage. So that's what our critical hits with our empowered smite looks like. Our exalted smite, rather. Pretty good, man. What about 8 years? Dude. DDO is a very, very, very different game than it was 8 years ago. Gently. Very different.
No, there is no wind.
Like, back then, DDO still clung pretty closely to 3.5. Now your high-level characters are gonna have, like, ACs of, like, 300 and... And you have things like, it's a very different game. if you know 3.5, you'll at least be able to pick like feats and stuff and like ability score assignment that won't like completely gimp you. But like, oh, nope, you need to die. Like they replaced the old skill trees, like, or the old enhancement point system. Now like you have proper skill trees in the game and stuff. It is very different. For better or worse. A very, very different game. Like, it used to be you couldn't solo anything. Now you can solo basically everything.
The sound of a door opening can be heard in the distance.
Oh, let's see. Can we do one more fight? We are almost out of mana. We should be good for this fight that's coming up here. I'll have to be cheeky and pull him. Yeah, Spoony now is a complete nut job. He used to at least be entertaining, and then he went like he needs some like serious mental help. Like he needs to be talking to some therapists and be on like some medication, because that dude has got problems. I feel bad for him. Like he's dude's fucked up. Okay, what else do we have? Some champions. Shadow marked. Dead. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna go back and rest. Top myself off. Okay, let's get some mana. And this should ideally also peel this curse off of us. If it doesn't, I'm gonna just chuck a potion. I debate on whether or not to put on resistances. I also keep forgetting that I have these potions of bark skin. Duration of 3 minutes here. We'll throw them down on our buff bar for, like, boss fights. I need to start using those, because I don't think we have any natural armor to AC. We do not.
The staircase descends several floors, ending in a dank tunnel carved into the earth.
Well, we've got a 50% chance for things to miss us. I guess that's not too bad. Okay, I have fire resistance. I want lightning resist. We're gonna be eating magic missiles. These fucking warlocks. Or evokers, rather. Also, apparently acid arrows, which are obnoxious, but decidedly less lethal. Sucker interrupted my spell. Jerk. You feel old? Yeah, it happens. Yeah, it is a. I'm not going to say a completely different game from 12 years ago, but it is a very different game from 12 years ago. Aw, man. See, that's why I don't miss cats. They pull shit like that. Then you, like, boot them out of the room, and then they sit outside and yowl, or they claw at your door, and then you open the door to let them in, and they just sit there, and they stare at you like you're a fucking dumbass. I don't miss that shit at all. Oh, no worries, Stormcrow. Cat that pushes. I mean, at least she opens and closes doors. You gotta train her to clean the litter box, and then there you go. That's like winning at life. I know some people can like have like taught their cats to like go in the toilet and stuff. It's just like, holy crap. Wizardry. Well, of course.
This chamber is
fuck! I forgot there were rust monsters. The air is a smell of rotting garbage. All right, let's gather all of y'all together. Be a coward. How's my weapon looking? Oh, bad ideas. I'm just gonna wade in, and I'm only gonna hit these things with cleaves. That way, I'm only damaging my weapon once, ideally, for every attack. Okay. And they're softened up. Of course, one left that just doesn't want to die. There we go. How's our sword? God damn! Took like almost a quarter of our weapon's durability to kill four rust monsters. This game. See a stream of Ultima Online? Man, that game has changed so much. If I wanted to go really far back, I'd end up playing like Meridian 59 or something. Maybe play some MUDs. I used to be huge on Batmud back in the day, but that was like 20 years ago. Why does this quest remind you of Against the Slave Lords? Because this quest is in fact Against the Slave Lords. We are seeking information on the Slave Lords, and we're trying to find their chamber, and then we are going to murder one of them. But yes, I think it's three quests long? It's a quest chain Against the Slave Lords. They've also added like White Plume Mountain and a bunch of like old stuff. Haunted Halls of Evening Star. There are traps here. Oh, that's interesting. So apparently my strike through works with my Exalted Smite. That is actually very good to know. That makes our Exalted Smite very, very powerful against groups. No Tomb of Horrors, no, sadly. They wouldn't be able to get away with something like that in DDO. People would whine too much that it was too hard. Here Yours is the nosy bastard type of cat. Those can be trouble in their own right. What's up, guys? Smite. I hit all four of them with that smite. Oh my lord. That's wonderful. Oh, that one evaded. The attack, like, isn't an AoE or something, is it? No. Huh. Interesting. Whenever the 5e MMO comes out. Are they... No, I'm thinking Lord of the Rings. I was gonna say, I don't know if they're gonna do a 5th edition MMO. I think it might depend on how well Baldur's Gate 3 does as to whether or not there's going to be more 5th edition games. Oh, let's see. Oh, Seth Zinch or whatever his name is. Alright, there are air traps, like, right up here. What I want to do is get close enough that they go off so that I can see the fucking things, but not so close that I get blown into the water. I'm going to get blown into the water. No, oh, there it is. I told you. I hate this. This hallway makes me hate this entire quest line because it is such a pain in the ass. It is like it does nothing except waste your time, time and time again. Well, I think his last name is like the same as the Chaos God from Warhammer. It also chaps my vitals that the enemies are immune to the traps. Okay. Oh, and of course they're not on the same, like, blowing pattern. I don't know how I made it past that considering I ran right through that air geyser, but I'll take it. And this is a clever trap right here. There are little pressure plates that throw ice traps, and then there's skeletons which are then immune to them. But these traps actually do affect enemies, usually. If we had enemies that were not skeletons, like these pressure plates would hurt them. Which is something that we'll be maybe abusing momentarily, we'll see. Like, that's the thing. I figure if they're gonna do the Tomb of Horrors in this, they're not going to do a quest that is just the Tomb of Horrors. They'd probably... Realistically, if they were gonna do it, they'd probably just port over the Tomb of Annihilation module from 5th edition, because it's, like, essentially, like, a little campaign, almost. Because, like, there's this huge build-up to actually getting to the tomb itself. And that would probably go over much better. But just like an original Tomb of Horrors, like this, the community behind this game would probably hate it. It's far too brutal. All you do is die. Unless you've played it, in which case you like avoid 99% of it because you know what you're doing. Yeah, exactly. Like, it was a tournament module and the sole purpose of it was like the ability to say, yeah, we somehow managed to cheese our way through this thing and nobody died. Which... I'd be curious to know if anyone ever legitimately got through that module without, like, people just dying. I would be very dubious that of anyone that said, oh yeah, we got through it and nobody died. Okay, now, against my better judgment, we're gonna backtrack. I wanna go back and hit those rest shrines. Well, the rest shrine. It was back by those rust monsters. Which means, sadly, we are going to have to deal with the air jets again. Yeah, that was, like, back with the Tomb of Horrors, that was, like, a different kind of climate when it came to con games. Like, you were playing, like, Judge's Guild stuff, and it was... God, how would I describe it? Not competitive, but... Like, the stuff was designed to be, like, super murder, like, PC grinder type stuff. Yeah, like that's kind of how I would look at it. It's like, oh, you beat the Tomb of Horror and nobody died, and your DM must have been holding your hands. Like, there's stuff in there that is just going to kill you. There's no way that you're gonna be able to figure some of the shit in there out that is just like you just like people are dying. Unless you're like pushing an army of like hirelings in ahead of you or whatever. Like, hell, just getting into the place, like, one of the three passages that you're going to pick arbitrarily, like, there's a block that falls down and you die. Like, okay. It's just so much arbitrary death. Oh, I hate this thing. Oh, terrible. Only one PC made it. You should look into the Tomb of Annihilation. It's basically like, I mean, I guess if you want to play 5th edition. It's basically, it's like the Tomb of Horror, but like much expanded into like an actual interesting dungeon. It's pretty cool. And there's like this huge like region set out before it and stuff. It's interesting. Hi guys. Seriously, come on. Come on. I know there's traps right in front of this thing. Seriously? Oh, there they go. Oh, that might have been the War Changer. We have to be careful about the Orc Ravagers. They trip you. Which is bad. Seriously? Oh. Yeah, you need to die. There should be traps here, but there are not traps here. Interesting. I wonder if the trap placement is randomized. We'll test momentarily. Because I know that there are also traps along here, usually. If there's dinosaurs to be had, you're in. Okay, good. Yeah, I think like in the Forgotten Realms, it takes place in like Chult or something, whatever the jungle region is. If I were to do it in, I wouldn't even know where I would set that in Pathfinder, like Aslant or something. Come on. No traps. Interesting. Me and my group ran this, there were like traps all over here. I wonder if it maybe changes trap layouts based on the number of people in the party or something. That would be cool. It is Chult, nice. Cheap plastic, hey, you know, you do what you gotta do. You buy a cheap plastic dinosaur, you paint a, you give it like just a quick coat of like even, God, I don't know, just like hit it with a wash or something and it'll look fine. Ain't nobody complaining when they're getting their faces eaten off by dinosaurs. Oh, the second edition box set. I sadly have never gotten my hands on the second edition box set for Tomb of Horrors. The only box sets I've ever fooled around with first, second edition are Dark Sun, and I've got the Ruins of Undermountain. I used to have the Birthright campaign setting, but I sold that ages ago. And you gotta watch out, those pencil sharpeners don't fuck around. Okay, this is gonna be a pain in the ass. Be a pain in the ass mostly because like we're going to have to dance around this shit. Oh, I fucked up. Nope. I don't like this puzzle purely because of these flame jets. Like, I can't sit and fool with it. Like, they make me have to dodge out every so often so I don't get immolated. Man, the Birthright campaign setting, I love the Birthright campaign setting. It is, ah, oh, it is so cool. It would make for a really interesting, like, higher power, like, mythic rules from Pathfinder campaign, I think. They even made a video game. There was a Birthright video game, Birthright the Gorgon's Alliance. It was terrible. And the, like, intro movie was narrated by Zordon from the Power Rangers. Oh, it was so bad. But nah, Birthright is pretty cool. Fuck me, that fire hurts. And they, of course, make this take the most meandering path. The moss clay stuff that people use? I have no idea what you're talking about. Beaches. Unless you're talking about, like, just general basing material, but that's not clay. I don't know. What witchery are you on about? Oh my god! Like, that's the thing, is, like, these things are hitting me for, like, 20 damage, and that's through 20 points of fire resistance. No joke to your trap damage. Well, like, the thing that I like about Birthright is that it's basically like Highlander, but a campaign setting. Like, you kill people, and if they have godblood, you absorb the godblood powers. Pretty great. Plus, it's what Rove is from, actually. Which is worse? Pool of Radiance, Ruins of Mithranor by a long shot. I actually quite like Stronghold. And the Birthright game actually holds like some childhood nostalgia for me. But yeah, of those three, I've actually streamed a little bit of Stronghold. I enjoy that game probably way more than is reasonable. Oh, let's see, oh shit. There are some nasty lightning traps along here that stun you. Oh, there it is. There it is. They knock you down, and then they just keep knocking you down because that's reasonable. Well, we might be in a bit of a pickle here. Ooh, made it through at least. And then there's a pack of monsters down at the end on the other side of a pile of these fucking things. Alright. Throwing knives of infinite range. And these guys should trigger the trap when they come to get me. Maybe. Yes? No? No? Fuck you, game! And you're... obnoxious bullshittery. I know there's lightning related death along here. Yeah. Ooh. Yeah, clerics are pretty good. I think when I streamed it, I had like this huge pack of adventurers since it was like the stream was winding down, and I just ended up like mobilizing all of my adventurers, completely ignoring the town, and just roving along the landscape, murdering everything. It was a pretty good time. Okay. I think we get a rest shrine after this room. I just have to get through this fight. Tentatively in one piece.
Quiet sobs echo from the cell below.
Sucks for you guys. Because this is the boss fight. Yeah. Is there not a rest shrine? There might not be a rest shrine. Shit. I'm thinking of, I think, either the next quest or the last quest. Because this is just a room full of jail cells down here. Shit. Alright, well. This is gonna be interesting. Thankfully, we have a bunch of wands and stuff. Alright. I don't know why I'm bothering with Owl's Wisdom. It's not going to do anything for us. Apple bark skin. We got buffs. Champions? No champions. All right. Yes. I am in fact a paladin, yes.
At a fine price. Once.
But I'm a DDO paladin.
Guards,
so those captured slaves get to just sit there and be captured. Whoever comes through here after me will save them. I want to kill all these fucking archers. He's dealing poison damage. That's obnoxious. Okay. I gotta get, like, I don't know. I'm trying to think. Get potions of heroism I should pick up. When we're done with this, we're gonna go to town. Ideally, I won't die. We're going to go to town, and I'm gonna do some potion shopping, I think. Ooh. Come on. 25 hit points left. Powered smite misses, we're good. Oof. That was close. Cork clay. Yeah, I've never heard of that. That sounds interesting. You know, if it's textured clay, I can definitely see how that would be useful. Like, you could do all kinds of nifty stuff with that.
The manifest describes a distance from
anything. Chains. That is slave trade. Trash item that's getting vendored.
The slave lords can doubtless be found there.
Whew. And we almost ranked up, but not quite. It does, however, look like we have mail. Who did I hit favor with? Maybe the gatekeepers? I don't know. Okay, so we are probably going to sell stuff, buy potions, and then I think I'm going to call it because we're not going to have enough time to run the next quest, I don't think, in the chain. However, we will be in a good place to pick it up next time. I don't know if I'm going to do Friday streams. I think I'm probably going to stick to bi-weekly, but we might go eventually swap to just weekly Friday streams. We'll see. See how I'm feeling. Keep an eye on the Discord, keep an eye on the Twitter, etc. I will announce what's going on as soon as I pull my head out of my ass and figure out what's going on. Okay, I also need to buy spell reagents, which we should be able to do here as well. Divine reagents. Do you have... You seriously? This dude doesn't sell paladin reagents. Just druid and clerics. Good, that's fucking wonderful. Screw you, buddy! Exactly. You go to Walmart and you buy the off-brand plus one size and they end up breaking midway through the dungeon, and then Walmart starts going on about how there's an iron shortage or something. Okay. So, potion-wise, I don't think this guy's gonna really have a whole hell of a lot. I mean, we can buy more potions of bark skin, I suppose, but I'll buy some. I don't really use these too much. I need to be better about using them. Don't need lesser restoration, don't need resists. We have blindness and curse removal. All right, so let's see. Scroll vendor. Good old Boulder's Gate. Okay, you don't really have anything I care about. Let's go to House Jarosco. See, everybody's happy that Minsk is coming back in Baldur's Gate 3, and it chaps my ass, because it takes, Baldur's Gate 3 takes place like 100 years or whatever after Baldur's Gate 2, So it's like post spell plague, post whatever 5th edition is done with it. The only reason that they brought mints back is because, oh, people are going to like this. It'll make them happy and it will probably generate sales. He's like basically the Baldur's Gate mascot, him and Boo. Like, it kind of makes me sad. Like, oh, he didn't die? How didn't he die? He was petrified. Ugh. Come on. Oh, I don't disagree. I love Minsk as a character. But he should be dead. Because it takes place 100 years after. And it rustles my jimmies. Why am I not selling? Oh, I bet you this stuff was damaged. I do not want to sell my feathers that I just bought, though. We need those. Okay. Let's see. You guys have any more interesting potions? Yeah, no, I'm happy that the fans are getting what they want out of it. Ooh, better bark skin potions. Those are tempting. As are potions of haste, actually. But no, heroism's the big one. I want, like, a stack of those. Heroism is great. It's like +2 to everything. Heroism is essentially bard song in a bottle. It's wonderful. He's very good. These potions of bark skin, these are +2. I can get ones of +3, but realistically our AC isn't going to be high enough to matter. So I'm going to pass on that. I am going to buy potions of haste, though. Putting all of the money that we have earned on liquids that will enhance my ability to not get butchered in combat. Or at least help me kill bosses a little faster. My downside is haste only lasts 30 seconds. Oh, that's painful. Let's see, some higher level protection from damage potions. Rage could be useful. Like, again, these are all really good, like, boss buffs. But again, do I want to be that fiddly? Because realistically, we should have heroism going all the time. And then these four are boss buffs. I'm going to pass on Rage, I think. Because Rage also fucks up your ability to cast spells, if I recall correctly. And that's less than ideal. So now, I think we want to go to the scroll place. House of Wizardry, and see if they have any divine scrolls that we can use. Hey kids, setting welcome. Glad to have you on board, although I'm actually just getting ready to end the stream, so. Rage also doesn't, oh yeah, you're right. Yeah, it won't stack with my my tank stance. Good point, I had not even thought of that. Let's see. Scrolls of Cure Serious. I could replace, no, we've got wands, we don't need scrolls. Can I use Cure Critical? No, alas. You guys have anything else? Not really. You don't care about enhancement potions? As I bisect this poor halfling just sitting here trying to earn a living. Do I have an extra Cure Serious wand? I do. Nope. Alright. So we are good, I think, as far as equipment goes for now. I'm sure there's probably some stuff I'm missing. I would like to get, like, Blur or something, but that would be within the realm of Use Magic Device. So we're probably just gonna have to hold off until we find some item that gives us Blur or, like, Ghostly or something. Which, there are some that we can get at this level range. I would just have to, like, farm quests for them and, I don't necessarily care enough to do that. So instead, let's go see what this mail is about, and we will call it. I need to get something to up my wisdom. Like, I've got something that's plus two. We have two empty equipment slots because the game is being unkind. Do I seriously only have a plus two to my charisma? Oh my lord! We should have like plus five to our wisdoms in charisma. They should be three points higher, at least. Rank of noted. That is the gatekeepers. We should probably do that, but I'm not going to. Instead, I'm going to forget about it and we'll get it the next time we're back there. I want to check the auction house really quick, because otherwise I'm going to forget. Like, we need something to pump up our charisma and our wisdom. If for no other reason than our healing, but it also gives us like saving throws and stuff. Okay, let's see. What are our current charisma and wisdom items? All right, so charisma's on our neck. Let's see, you guys got any good necklaces? Not really. Not really at all. What about at 11th level? That would be good on a favored soul if you were, like, alternating between nuking dudes and healing people. Okay, and we have wisdom on our goggles. Oh, we get some dex goggles. Oh no, that's seeker. I always think deft is dexterity. Clever is intelligence. Prudent is wisdom, I think. Yeah. Of open lock. We could be popping some locks. God damn. Yeah, nothing available, sadly. Oh well. Regardless, on that note, I do think I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So, as usual for some folks, I hope y'all had a good time, and I will see you either next Friday or the Friday after that. Until then.